Well, guys, the time has come. 118 cars have been processed. So we had to depollute each one, drain the fluids, cut the cat off, take the gas tank out, drain the gas tank, take the rims and tires, separate them, take last minute goodies from each one. And there's about one engine, one transmission per vehicle. 118 cars. I would not have been able to do it without my family, but it was a long time coming, a ton of work, and a lot of long days. I was starting my day at 4:30 in the morning. These cars are not worth anything. Yeah, it was a ton of work. I had the help of my family, so we were able to muscle through it, but yeah, it was a lot of cars. So we decided to go this route instead of using the bins, just because of the uncertainty with trucking, and you know, they're having problems getting truckers themselves to haul the loaded bins and empty bins around. So this is the direction we went. One shot, should be done this week. Yeah, there's a lot of work that goes into processing these vehicles, you know, and taking, you know, scrap aluminum off of some of them, and you know, it's just been a monumental task. I got a whole bunch of skids here because we cleaned up whole bunch here. I've got some more shipments of cores to go out. But yeah, it's been a ton of work, and it's kind of the bittersweet, the end of an era, and time to move on. So gonna be cashing out. Luckily the market has held somewhat steady, but we'll see what happens in the next few months. There's a lot of uncertainty in the future. I still have 2C containers, but I think I might have a game plan for those, but we'll have to talk to the guy when he gets here. But yeah, it's been a ton of work. It's so much bigger in here now. So this is 1 acre, but really opens things up quite a bit when you have all the space cleared up by, you know, putting them the way that they are. But wow, it was a monstrous task.